This is part 4 of Azure tutorial. In our previous two videos, we discussed Azure data centers and geographies. In this video, we'll discuss Azure regions, region pairs, availability zones, update domains, fault domains, zonal, and zone redundant services. There's a lot of ground to cover, so let's get cracking. Quick recap first. What is an Azure data center? An Azure data center is a unique physical building that contains thousands of physical servers with its own power, cooling, and networking infrastructure. These data centers are located all over the globe. As of November 2020, there are over 160 plus Azure data centers worldwide. It is these data centers that are the building blocks of global Azure infrastructure. What is an Azure geography? Well, it's an area of the world that contains one or more Azure regions. For example, India, United States, United Kingdom are a few examples of Azure geographies. Why are Azure geographies important? Well, for two reasons. First, let's say all of your customers are in India. You don't want to host your application somewhere in the United States. You don't want every request and the associated data traveling around the world. This causes unnecessary latency, delay, and hence poor performance. You want your application and data to be hosted as geographically close to your customer base as possible. Since all our customers are in India, we want to make sure our application and data is hosted in India. One way Azure ensures this is by using geographies. Another reason is compliance with regulations. Regulated data like financial, healthcare, or credit card data, for example, may not be allowed to leave the country. Legally, your organization is required to store such data in the same country where the operations are being carried out. Again, Azure ensures this by using geographies. So, for example, if you select India as the geography, Azure ensures your data is always stored in India, except for certain global services. Now, what is an Azure region? Simply put, an Azure region is a set of data centers, and these data centers are connected through a dedicated low latency network. How many data centers does a region contain? Well, we do not have a fixed number. It varies. There are regions of different sizes. A region could be made up of just one data center or multiple data centers. The point is, an Azure region is a group of one or more Azure data centers. As of this course recording, Azure has 58 regions worldwide. You have the flexibility to deploy your applications and data to any Azure region you want. You can even deploy across multiple regions to deliver cross-region resiliency. Now, you might be wondering, what's meant by cross-region resiliency? Well, in general, resilience is the ability of a software to react to problems in one of its components and still provide the best possible service. So the point is, both your software and the underlying infrastructure must be resilient. If there is a problem, the end user should not know about it. The request must be handled and processed by another region. The end user should get the same level of service. We can get this resiliency by deploying our application and data in at least two regions. In this example, we have our application and data deployed in two regions, region A and region B. If there is a region level failure, for example, let's say region A has gone down, the Azure Traffic Manager is smart enough to send all the requests to region B. The end user gets the same response. It does not even know there is a region level failure. When region A is back online, the Azure Traffic Manager will distribute the traffic between both the regions again. Why are Azure regions important? Well, because every time we create an Azure resource, like a virtual machine, for example, we need to specify the Azure region where we want this resource to be created. Let's quickly look at this in action. At the moment, I am logged into my free Azure account. Even you can create a free Azure account. Just search the internet with the search term "create free Azure account." After you log in, you should be able to create a virtual machine. Notice on this page, we have region drop-down list. And within this drop-down list, we can see all the Azure regions. So here we select the Azure region where we want our virtual machine to be created. Now, what is an Azure availability zone? Well, availability zone is a unique physical location within an Azure region. Each availability zone is made up of one or more data centers with independent power, cooling, and networking. Not all regions have availability zones. Regions that support availability zones have a minimum of 3 separate zones to ensure resiliency. If one of the availability zones has gone down for some reason, we still have our applications and data available from the rest of the 2 availability zones. There is a physical separation between each availability zone, and it is this separation that protects our application and data from data center failures. With availability zones, Azure offers industry best 99.99% virtual machine uptime SLA. SLA, by the way, stands for Service Level Agreement. Next, let's understand fault domains and update domains. An availability zone is a combination of a fault domain and an update domain. For example, if you create 3 virtual machines across 3 zones in an Azure region, your virtual machines are effectively distributed across 3 fault domains and 3 update domains. For some reason, if there is a power failure or power surge, equipment failure, or some other fault in availability zone 1, only availability zone 1 is affected. As the availability zones are physically separated from each other, faults from one availability zone are not spread to the other availability zones. Since in this example, we have 3 availability zones, it's like we have 3 separate fault domains. If there is a fault and availability zone 1 is down, we still have our virtual machine available from the rest of the 2 fault domains, that is availability zones 2 and 3. Similarly, if there is an update or a patch to be applied, Azure schedules these at different times for different availability zones. So this means we have just one of the availability zones affected while the update is being applied. The rest of the 2 zones are unaffected. In our example, since we have 3 availability zones, the updates will be applied at 3 different times. So even if the virtual machine from availability zone 1 is down due to the update being applied, we have the rest of the 2 virtual machines still up and running, that is the VMs in availability zones 2 and 3. Zonal and zone redundant services. Now, if you want to make the best use of availability zones and then build high availability systems, you'll have to identify your compute, storage, networking, and data resources within an availability zone and then replicate them in the other availability zones. Azure services that support availability zones are classified into 2 categories, zonal services and zone redundant services. First, let's take a look at zonal services. Virtual machine is an example of a zonal service. A zonal service is pinned to a specific availability zone. This means it's only available in the availability zone where we created it. It's not automatically replicated to other availability zones. So if you want to build highly available systems, identify zonal services, such as a virtual machine, for example, and replicate them in other availability zones. Other examples of zonal services are managed disks and standard IP addresses. Azure SQL database, on the other hand, is an example of zone redundant service. These zone redundant services are automatically replicated by the Azure platform across all availability zones. Unlike zonal services, we don't have to replicate them manually. What are Azure paired regions? Well, Azure regional pair, paired regions, or region pair, all these terms are used interchangeably and they refer to the same thing, that is, a pair of Azure regions. So, in simple terms, a regional pair consists of 2 regions within the same geography. As you can see from the image, at the highest level, we have an Azure geography. As we have already discussed, an Azure geography is an area of the world that contains one or more Azure regions. For example, India, United States, Europe, Asia Pacific are a few examples of Azure geographies. An Azure region is made up of one or more data centers. If availability zones are enabled, an Azure region contains a minimum of 3 availability zones. An availability zone is made up of one or more data centers. So the point that I'm trying to make is an Azure region contains one or more data centers or 3 or more availability zones if enabled. Most regions in a geography are paired to ensure business continuity and disaster recovery. This is commonly known by the acronym BCDR, Business Continuity and Disaster Recovery. The following are a few examples of Azure paired regions. For Canada geography, we have Canada Central paired with Canada East. For China, China North with China East. India, Central India with South India. Japan East with Japan West. And finally, East US with West US. For the complete list, please check out the Microsoft official docs. So, a regional pair consists of two regions within the same geography. However, there's one exception to this. Brazil's South region is paired with South Central US region, which obviously is outside of Brazil's geography. Now, one question you might have at this point is, can I select the regions that I want in a region pair? Well, the answer is no, you can't. Regions in a region pair are determined by Microsoft. We do not have any control over it. However, you're not limited to using just the regions in one given region pair. You can, of course, create your own business continuity and disaster recovery solutions by deploying in any number of regions. Obviously, if they're deployed across regional pairs, we will have better business continuity and disaster recovery. Now, the benefits of paired regions. Physical separation between data centers. When possible, there is at least 300 miles of separation between data centers in a regional pair, although this isn't practical or possible in all geographies. Physical data center separation reduces the likelihood of natural disasters, civil unrest, power outages, or physical network outages affecting both regions at the same time. So, for whatever reason, if one of the regions is down, we still have the other region available. Region recovery in the event of an outage. If, for whatever reason, several regions worldwide are down, Azure prioritizes recovery of one region out of every pair. So, if you want your apps and data to be highly available, deploy them in paired regions. With this setup, if both the regions are down, Azure prioritizes to recover at least one region from the pair so we have our apps and data available again soon. If applications are deployed across regions that are not paired, recovery might be delayed. In the worst case, the chosen regions may be the last two to be recovered. Automatic platform-provided replication. Some services, such as geo-redundant storage, provides automatic replication to the paired region. This is a great benefit. In an event where one of the regions go down, you still have the data available from the other region in the region pair. Data residency, compliance, and legal requirements. With the exception of Brazil South, regions within a region pair are from the same geography. So this helps us meet data residency, compliance, and legal requirements. Sequential system updates. From time to time, patches and software updates need to be applied. Regions in a region pair are never updated simultaneously at the same time. They are always applied sequentially. This reduces the downtime to a great extent. If the planned update contains any bugs or logical errors, only one region is affected. Our apps and data are still available from the other region in the region pair. On the map right here, you can see the currently available Azure regions and availability zones. In this video, I've covered quite a bit of ground, so please don't worry if some of the terms and services are a bit confusing at the moment. We will be revisiting most of these several times as we progress through the course. We'll also see them practically in action. So I assure you, you'll get quite comfortable with them as we progress through the course. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.